boys. We back. Back at the grind. Check it out. Just built this custom made front bumper splitter for the racing track hatch boss. Brackets. This is gonna go like this. This on the other side. Pardon. Like this. That mounts to your bumpers, four holes, four screws, splitter, cut wind. Helps the guys to air induction intake, etc. Whatever. Anything you guys could think of. Custom ND fabs. Reason I'm trying it because it's gonna get carbon fiber wrap. After that, I'm gonna put it on the hatch. See how it looks. Some people might not like it. Some people might not dig it. But this is my style. It's something that I wanted to do for a while. I'm doing a lot of D.i.Y.s, like I told you guys, a lot of custom parts in the channel. This is another one, the same way that we did the racing track build hatch wing a while ago. We did the front end custom. Let me see. The fenders, we did custom white and front end fenders with the cutout bands. Now we're doing the MD Fabs aluminum racing side curves, so we're going to keep spending. We got delete plates for like radio bends. We could do that. You just gotta send me your car specifications. But yeah, show you a preview on that. You want a carbon fiber wrap the look? Get a carbon fiber wrap to see the look. And from there, we are proceed to install it. So let's get it. All right, boys. So I carbon fiber wrapped it. Here's the final look with the brackets. This is how it goes. This mounts against the bumper, obviously front bumper. You got one mounting screw, two mounting screw, three and four. So it'll be two bolts in each side, so these will not go anywhere. It's pretty much just a self-tap. They mount. These are for the EG track hatch. I'm going to be making them for self. People like them. These are front bumper splinters for the track hatch. These help the wind reduce it, guide it to the turbo intake, whatever you want. This does it all. So it applies to many cars. This is the one-off. First one is going on my hatch. Going to have the MD fab decals like everything else. Just figure I'd give you a heads up what it looked like. So this is on your interest, hit me up, my Dr. Productions, Instagram. But that's the final look, boys. Alright, boys. First logo that I put on. It looks so good. I never thought I'd be making my own car parts for racing. Pause. Like, this is a dream come true. And have my own name brand, my own logo is just something that word can't express how I feel. You know what I'm saying? That somebody's gonna rock worldwide and they're gonna represent, you know what I'm saying, and they're gonna like it. So we got the logo on one side, save the other side. We're gonna carbon wrap it and put the logo. We'll do that on camera, but I'll show you guys how it's gonna look. Apologies. The final look right there. So it's a matter of yours getting the right bolts, installing it, and seeing how it looks. It looks good, man. It looks so good. Love how the carbon fiber look with the white coloring. So, yeah. I'm going to do the other side. Show you guys putting the logo on it. And from there, we'll see, you know, how things is picking up. Let's get it. All right, boys. So I put you on into the process of making. So far, designed it yesterday, put it on my story. I created this one today. You guys see? Posted it. Saw my first one, luckily and thankfully. This is the support I was looking for. And the response when you do good things and you humble. So it's going to come with the bracket for the first set. Bolts, watchers, and chip, $40 a piece. I'm blessing one of my brothers for $25 for the first set. For these bumper splinters for the track. So, I got my templates already. These are ready to get cut, get made. One is sold. But if I got maybe another six plates, I'm going to make six in total and sell them at one time. And it's going to be a new item in the channel besides the size curve that we're going to have. MD Fat production, so hype, bro. I'm hype. I just posted it on my story yesterday. Then mine's today. One of the Gunners, one of my boys, supporter, he liked it. Asked me for my info quick. And it's already sold. So we're going to be sending out my loyalty. Anyway, so put you on how I'm doing the stickers. Put my lighting a little bit so you guys see. Looking in time, so I'm doing the skirts. So I'm doing the skirts, I'm making extra stickers, killing time, so that way I have the skirts or any product like that. I have the stickers already done, just a matter of slapping them on the product component, like I said, and get them going. So I'll go on my laptop here, computer, whatever. Get the program already, the amount, over here, quantity. Go back, I want two because of the size. You can only fit so many times at the time. You got it. Hit cut now. Press the recording, guys. Just like that, I will make the label for it over. Wait a couple minutes, second touch. Figure I share with you guys and give you a heads up how things get done. So I literally got about 10 of them. Plan to have like 20 done out of a rip. There's gonna be fabs, just like that. So I'll reset it. Give me another two. Like I said, I'm trying to have at least like 20 ready. So whatever I make anything, this custom build here, I could put the logo of the brand and shit. Got the wrong program there. You go here. Hit quantity. Press 2. Come now. Let's see what cutting. Yes. Just like that. So if I get myself ahead of time and get around 20 or 30, it'll save me the time to go and have to make them all the time. It's a matter of just slapping it on the product at the end. That's it. Repeat the process a couple of times. Like I said, I'm trying to save time later, so if I could cut 20, 25 right now, that'd be good. I don't have to sit down another day and make them and save it. Even though I'm going to save it, but I have it now. So time consuming. The smartest way would be to have more so I could do mass production. So I'm going to get these done, and I'm going to clean them, get them on the trans paper, and I'll show you guys the final product. So they're good. Alright, boys, so we finished. We got the stickers already done. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 stickers. Enough to start quite of a size skirt. To be honest, I have 8 pairs with times 16. So I'll do one more and I have 4 each size skirt, all for the bumper splitters that I'm making. So the thing is that I'm getting myself ahead of time, excuse me, and having the stickers prepared so I don't have to go on and do them later on and have to remeasure them. It's just a matter of putting the trans paper, cut them, sticker, and pow, brand name is done. So with that said, let's get it. Boys, so we're back. You came from the hardware store. Things is going up, boys. 3 spray cans to paint the side skirts. Put you guys on a little bit and put it on your chains. You got 3 semi-gloves, paws, personal cans for the side skirts. I bought all the hardwares for the skirts that I'm going to be selling, you guys know. All the lug nuts, all the watchers. Man, times have changed, boys. Now I believe why they said that yesterday's price is not today's price. By the time they you add up, 26 at 30, 33 at 45, 47 at 60. But all the screws that I need for the hardware for the cypress, right? $119, guys. And the 3 spray cans and the screws for the MDS aluminum racing side skirts for the lug nuts. Since I'm providing it in the side skirts, as you guys know, it's my part of my job. It is my business, my small company. I gotta provide, so yeah. But I don't know, UT. That's what business I was supposed to do, so it was just to show you guys. 119, just in this. Only so that I could do enough for 16 skirts that I have right now at the moment. I got about 25 more in my job. So, yeah, things are getting pricey, boys. Now, what I'm doing, I'm getting prepped. I'm prepping a closet that I have Show you guys in a little bit. I'm gonna turn that into my closet slash working shop because everything is compromised. The garage is full, my chair is full, the basement not proper. So I'm gonna have an area where I could storage the aluminum, have my bolts, make stickers as you guys seen already cut. I'm trying to have them that you guys order these size cards, these products, and have them available like boom, immediately the next day that I could ship them out. So that I'm doing everything the way it is. All these groups, they're gonna get storage over here, so I have them at all times. So I'm gonna be like vents for it, so it'll be organized. You get what it looked like and the progress on making this business. So stay tuned. So we got it all sorted out. I got the screw that I was missing for my boy EJ6 tank. If you're watching this, apologies, bro. I was in a rush doing the video, doing his plates, and I miscalculated and I sent on the amount for one side of the size screw. He was very cooperative with me, understanding. He spoke to me, so I'm sending this right away. I got my other extra screws already set up. So this is pretty much how the bench is going to be. I'm going to have the screws with the lug nuts ready. Drop the lug nuts, excuse me, you see. So it just matches the size easier for me. Smaller screws, smaller lug nuts, so it matches. Longer screws for the size of the side curves for the frame. Actually, where the record panels mount. Watches extra. So little by little, I'm going to build up my supply equipment, because I'm gonna have more bolts. Right now I got enough for the side skirts. This is how it's looking, guys, with the screws. This is what it's gonna look like. I just got the screws for it, so it's gonna be small. This is ready to tie it up, mounting my hatch, and it's that simple. So it's been a simple video today, hopefully something that you guys like. This is definitely something that's mass production. I already got one sold to one of my brother gunners. I just gotta make it and send that out to him. This is the first one for my hatch. I didn't want to do like the first time on the size curve that I did the first pair and I didn't get to really enjoy it. But I'm not crying about it, you know, business is business. So this time I did the first item. I'm rocking the first item. I already got an order, so I already got the template here, as you guys see. Show you, same thing. I made the copy, so I have it all the time. So right now I have two of these available. I'm going to bring more metal this week. So I have these ready cut for when people order them. They don't have to wait, you know what I'm saying? So these are ready to get cut. And get carbon fiber wrap, put stickers, put the brackets just like that, and get ready to get sent. I already got one sold, so I got one extra. So we're back. I decided to take 3 days off from my work. Some people pay super good, believe me. That's why I've been neglecting the garage a little bit. However, I decided to take this week, because it's Easter, to spend with the family and stuff like that. So let's work on the cars. So we're working on the front splinter today. We're gonna see. But we've been having also a little issue. That's why I've been holding on videos a little bit in the garage. My door is messed up, so I'm tight with my landlord because I paid him for the garage. You know what I'm saying? It's been like 2-3 months I can open the door properly. So they come in and fix it. One of the wires on this side snapped, so the door, it bent on me one time, almost hit the hatch. It almost hit me on half. Like, if, you know, I was trying to crawl down, it almost hit me. So don't worry that they're gonna fix it. Because I do use the garage. It's electronic with a remote, you can't just open it by hand. So I'm glad they come in to fix that. But we're gonna install that at some point. We're gonna open it so we can install that. And then from there, we see how things go for the day. All right, boys. So check out the new slap sticker. Here goes another one. Another great giveaway from Keep Gunning. That I entered, by the way. Good luck to all my brothers. Your loyalty. Hope everybody best of luck. For all new people who are new, check out the Keep Gunning channel, KG Garage. And you gotta check it out. That's all I gotta say. So. My sticker about to lay it someplace. So far I got from Kobe, and we got from Lefty, we got from the RSK, message from Oren, and from Scarlet. But putting all the drip in the car, you know, from all the giveaways, so let's get it. Hey boys, so we're over here back in the garage after the garage door got fixed. We're looking out to my my landlord, and he's a handyman people. Blessed him with $40 just because I need the garage door. It's a blessing. I don't have to, you know, be hassling. Anyway. I'm installing the splinter and I run into a problem, so everything happened for a reason. I like the width and the length. I don't really like the big ones they make. So I run into the problem that I have nowhere or know how to mount it. So I was scratching my head like, man, how can I do something else? And I came up with the configuration. I got these plates. So I measure it to the length where I want it. It's gonna hook up to this like this. Same concept. Just a little more hooking up, so it's like a bracket, it's gonna connect that. So I gotta do that for all vehicles for different applications. They adjust, you know. You gotta tell me the length, I'll cut it. just minor setback. I'm glad it happened to me so I could figure it out. And that's pretty much how it goes. Now this play, don't bracket right there, it's not gonna go under. But this is gonna hook up into the play himself. The play hooks up into the bumper. So it's a matter of just drilling the hole real quick, through the bolts, hardware, remove these brackets, and you guys see what I mean. And I think it's gonna be a little more stylish rather than just some brackets in the corner. It's a bit heavy, not really much, but good aluminum, so it's worth it. And at the end, we do put some weight in the front for, you know, traction at the track, so why not? A couple ounces more is not gonna hurt us, so we get it. All right, boys, so I'm gonna show you my configuration to my problem, which I'm glad that in the prototypes, I run into problem just if a customer order it, so they run into the same issue, I gotta cover it. So I have some hardware here. We use, gonna go inside, show what the prototype looked like. So there you go, boys. Final product, looking at it. This is the bracket I was able to make to have that measurement. As you see, I have the brackets already in place. The screws are secure. There you go. Check it out. Now you got it mounted on the hatch. Problem solved. To be honest, it gives it a sicker look. You know what I'm saying? Bracket mount to this plate. The plate itself mounts to the bracket. And all four brackets mount into the bumper, so it should be ready. You know what I'm saying? It's a little bit more of an aggressive look. So, not far away, we're gonna install it, you know, see what it looks like, so let's get it. Alright, boys, so I have to charge it. Battery died real quick. I forgot to show you the motor. I cleaned it the other day. Couldn't really get into there too much, but at all here in the engine bay, as much as I get, the radiator, the hose, trans, everything that I could have, I greased it. So it looked like mad clean. Not too bad, though. Alright, back to what we gotta do. Alright, boys, check it out. How the product looking. We're about to install it on the track hatch. It was the perfect moment to move the daily. Kind of a photo shoot moment. Represent. Definitely a little good, man. So the daily. Yeah, like, you know, I'm interested on this hatch. Looking at it in the hatch in the channel. And this is the new corn splitter that we came out with. So check it out. Alright, boys. I know they put the hatch back. I had to make space for my four-wheeler to put it back in my shed because it was taking too much space on my garage. Now we're back to that grind mode. Looking good. Right. After they're waiting, we're gonna do the installation. So let's get it. I made it just so that you can put it running, hiding any bump like you guys see. This is not going anywhere. So, that's a hell of a project. I'm making parts that could be useful, that I can use in my car that probably could use. So if you're not getting awesome, it's not going to follow that. Look. That looks like an expert. perfect with. So you're doing a walk around the hatch. She was sick. Many upgrades, many DIYs done here in the channel. A street budget racing track hatch built in the channel. For you guys that are into it, maybe you got a hatch. Maybe it don't have to be a hatch. It could be a sedan, it could be a coupe, it could be a F, it could be an Acura. And you naturally aspirate it, but you tired of that regular grocery girl look and you want to get into the track look. It's a good temple in this channel. All this car called a Wolverine. This car came here as a shell. Go back to my previous video. We started with the record panels on her and look at it now. From custom track win, built here, DIY in the channel, to custom decals, also built here, to custom front end built here in the channel, from the beginning to the end. You'll go on the playlist. From doing a cutout bends, also DIY in the channel, check out the playlist again. Those are gems for you guys to come and learn. Splinters, DIY in the channel now, for you guys to learn how to do stuff like that. Also, they are for sale on the market. As I said, they were $40 a piece, but with the bracket configuration that came out, a little bit more work, more bolts, but more precise, we'll have different adjustments. $60, you can't go wrong. You know, it's a brand that's gonna rise up eventually, sooner or later, you know what I'm saying? Like I always say, this is a people's champ, you know what I'm saying? It's with the underdog have a voice. It's a brand, you know, for the outcast. Everybody, they know how it's always been that, you know, just we always getting refused and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? So we are our own brand. We show that we can make it, you know what I'm saying? We are the upgrade. Fuck the upgrade. But yeah, everything's looking good. It's looking money. Custom win, like I said. CCC racing, side skirts in the side. Eventually, I'm going to put my own MD fabs side skirts in here. Just for now, I'm working on having them ready to get shipped. Because I got a few orders, so you know what I'm saying? It's not all about me. I'm trying to share with you guys as well. That's already sold one. So far, my story is on the Splinter. I pointed it out. And one of the Gunner Brothers is interested on that one. He's going to purchase a duplicate. I got a couple plates extra done. So, yeah, what can I say, man? She's looking dope. Starting to look like a single four-wheel drive car, little by little. Just need the slicks, the rims. Maybe good money. Like I said, the K24 is coming to life soon. I got some more gems coming up. Stuff that I'm getting for her that I got the hour. I just can't give out too much details right now, but stay tuned. The K24 bill. Natural aspirated. 85% of it done here in the channel. From bodywork to custom parts to paint to vinyl wrap. Pretty much everything. It's a little bit of everything here in the channel. So I hope you guys like. For those that have subscribed, like and comment, I appreciate every single one of you. Until next time. Peace. Every bitch you fuckin' gon' come with a balance. Every shooter with me is